like I'm about to do something that no one has ever done before. Yo, I'm scared. I'm about to put my business out there. Channel. My name is Alex and I am applying to law school this application cycle. I'm about to do something that no one has ever done before and document my application process in real time. It's about to get real, y'all. It's literally about to get so fucking real. Most of the YouTube videos available right now are just application cycle recaps where they talk about it after they've decided where to go to law school. In an effort to be as transparent, as real, and as vulnerable as I've been on my TikTok, and if you guys don't know, I started my platform there. Follow me if you haven't already. If you're planning on applying to law school this cycle and stuck on what your personal statement should be, you have to listen to this. I recently attended a T14 law school info session, and here's what the Dean of Admissions had to say about personal statements. I am choosing to vlog everything in real time and share the process with you. So besties, this is me welcoming you guys to part one of my applying to law school series in real time. I'm an R&R student, which means I chose to retake and reapply. And the first time that I was applying to law school, it was very, very lonely.
I hate it here.
I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't even know how much work people put into studying for the LSAT. So the main motivation for me starting this series is to hopefully make you guys feel less alone and know that there's somebody else that's going through this same exact process. And we're gonna see each other through the other side, hopefully. Whew, I'm nervous. I'm really, really nervous because you never know where the application process will take you. So in this video, I'm gonna take you guys through my game plan and also my to-do list for the week. My two main goals this application cycle is one, have all of my essays complete by October 20th, and two, submit all of my applications by October 31st. Halloween is a hard deadline for me, and there's two main reasons why I want to submit my applications super early in the cycle, even though it doesn't end until February, March, is one, I want to get a very good scholarship package, and the only way to do that is to submit as early as I can, and two, I'm just gonna keep it real with y'all, bestie got a low GPA, okay? Very, 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 very. So in order for me to be competitive or to even have a shot of getting into law school, I have to submit as early as I can. Whew, yeah. That means that every single day of October has to count for me. No off days. This is crunch time and I'm gonna take you guys with me. I work a full-time job. I'm gonna be editing these videos, which I did not know takes a while, okay? And three, work on my law school applications. Okay, now moving on for this week's to-do list. So number one and most important thing that I have to do is finish my second personal statement.
So I already have a completed personal statement from last year's application cycle, but I wanted to write a second one just to kind of compare the two and also to maybe blend them together and see what works.
It is absolutely imperative for me to have a very strong personal statement because like I told you guys, I have a really, really low GPA. It was a
2.77.
Yes, y'all, my GPA is that low. In order for me to have the strongest personal statement that I can have, I hired an application service and y'all, it was expensive, okay? It was a lot of money. $200, but it is unlimited revisions and edits just for personal statements. I don't wanna disclose the name of the company yet because I did get some mixed reviews on them, but as soon as I'm done with them, I will definitely give you guys a review and let you know how that experience went for me. Another resource that I'm using for my personal statement is Grammarly. If you guys don't know, English is not my first language. I'm an immigrant from the Philippines and there's still some words and like verbs that I kind of get confused with. So I wanted to pay for Grammarly to kind of make sure that those little mistakes don't go unnoticed. Something else that I have to figure out this week is where I'm applying to law school. There's a really a small amount of places that I'm willing to live in for the next 3 years and basically be in jail for. Like, I can't go nowhere. I'm gonna be in that place for 3 years. That's 365 times three. Do the math, because I can't, okay? My two deciding factors on where to apply to law school is one, diversity, both in the location and in the law school that I'm hoping to attend, and two, location. I'm a city girl, okay? The city girls, and you know where I'll fuck you. I'm from South Florida. I need to be in a metropolitan space. You know what I'm saying? I can't be in a country. I can't do it. Some people be applying to like New Haven or Milwaukee or like Kansas, and I'm like, ugh, that ain't for me. I respectfully decline. So my main locations for law school is DC, Atlanta, Texas, and Florida. So the last two things I have to do is one, start filling out my LSAC applications. That usually doesn't take a while because once you've filled one application out, it kind of autofills the rest of them. And two, outline my additional statements. So that includes my optional essays and my addendas that I have to do. Besties, I'm so excited to share this experience with you guys. I feel like we're gonna have a lot of fun. If you guys are applying to law school this cycle too, or thinking about applying, leave a comment down below and let's kiki it up. You know what I'm saying? Big cup of act, I'm drowsy. I'm still posted up where you first found me. Did I just read that you just got engaged on me? I heard from your friend, you couldn't even tell me. I better yet, wait on me. Nah, sha-na-na, na-na-na. Sha-na-na, na-na-na. Can't just leave it up that way.
Hey everyone, happy Tuesday. It's October 3rd. I got off work at like 3:30 and I just came to the clubhouse in my apartment to work on my personal statement. I'm not gonna lie, it's not hitting how I wanted to. It's still sounding like a journal entry more than an essay, but I really think that this is the best that it's gonna get, and I'm just gonna have to submit it to the application service and see what kind of feedback they give me.
Feeling a little bit sick, so for the rest of the night, I think I'm just gonna work on my LSAC applications and probably outline my optional statements and optional essays that I have to do for some other schools. Hopefully that'll get my creative juices flowing. I don't know. I honestly think I have writer's block, or I just need some type of inspiration. I don't know, but I'll keep you guys posted. Can't
just leave it off that way. Hi besties, happy Wednesday. I can't believe it's already October 4th. Like, this week is just going by so fast, and this whole month is just going by so fast. I don't know. I feel like tomorrow I'll wake up and it's already Halloween, but today I am working on my highest reach school. I'm applying to 1T14 law school, and they have an optional essay and a short answer response. So I'm gonna work on those two today. Hopefully I can get it done by tonight and then just do a little bit of revising and editing tomorrow. Last night I made a checklist of all of the additional documents, essays, and personal statements that each law school that I'm applying to requires. I'm gonna just slowly work through that the next couple weeks and see where that takes me. I'm hoping to have every single essay done, like I said, by October 20th. So I really gotta grind these essays out at least by the next 2 weeks, because I am about to have a crazy October. I'm moving. I have to go to a work training. I usually work from home, but I'm gonna go in person in like 2 weeks. So that's gonna mess up my schedule a little bit, but I'm really hopeful that I get a lot of stuff done this weekend. Each do I get an invitation or something, a statement or something? Ask about that, you would say it was nothing. Well, here's another nothing that you made into something. Hi besties, happy Thursday. Late last night, I received the revised personal statement from the application service that I hired, and
I'm not gonna lie, I'm disappointed. Like, I don't know what I was expecting, but the revised statement that I got was super cookie cutter and generic. And I don't know if like that's what law schools want, because my personal statement, the first one that I submitted last year, was very, very personal and it told a story. But I feel like this one, they just cut out everything and just made it super like impersonal, if that even makes sense. So what I did is I asked the help of one of these really big TikTok influencers. I connected with her earlier this summer and she agreed to review my personal statement. And I'm so thankful because I trust her and I know that she's gonna give me the feedback that I need. Maybe I'm overthinking. I don't really know how it works. So I'm waiting to hear back from her. It's already 8 o'clock and usually I'm like in bed by then, but I am gonna edit this YouTube video and also work on my optional statement for the T14 law school. So that's what I'm doing for the rest of the night. I hope you guys are having a wonderful week so far because I am having a stressful one, okay? Can't just leave it off that way.
Hi besties, happy Friday! I am so happy to report that we got almost everything done on our to-do list, so.
I know I said earlier this week that I was gonna do a second personal statement, but one, I feel like my story, I just can't tie it into law school, even though it's a really good story. So I decided to scrap that, and I'm completely just reworking my first personal statement with the application service that I hired.
I received the first edit back from them and I did some changes and I submitted it back to them, so we'll see what they say. As far as the law schools I'm applying to, right now I have 8. I filled out all the LSAC stuff for it. I'm just working on the individual essays and I'm still deciding on whether or not I should add 1 or 2 more to my application list. So I'm probably gonna do some research next week and finalize that and hopefully submit my applications in 3 weeks. Another thing that I did this week is I submitted my resume to my mentor and she's gonna review and edit it, make some changes over the weekend and hopefully have it back to me by early next week so that I can add it onto my LSAC applications. As far as essays, I only have 4 left, but they're all 1-page double space, so I'm not worried. I'm hoping to finish rough drafts for all 4 of them by this weekend. And I feel like I can do that. I can make that happen and then just edit throughout next week and hopefully have it all done by October 20th. I really, really need October 20th to be the day that I have all of my essays completed and finalized because I am going out of town that week for work and I need to get my shit together by then, okay? I'm very positive that I'm gonna get it done though because when I tell y'all, I don't do nothing, okay? I don't do nothing but write these essays, dream about these essays, think about these essays. When I'm in the shower, I think about these essays. When I'm using the restroom, I think about these essays. Like, my whole life are these essays, basically. So, it is safe to say that part 1 of my applying to law school series was very, very productive. I'm so excited to take on this journey with you guys and I can't wait to see you guys in the next video. Bye, besties.